Hello, I'm Johnny Cash.
I hear the train a-coming, it's rolling around a bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps a-rolling on down to San Antone. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. Bet there's rich folks eating from a fancy dining car. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free. But those people keep a moving, and that's what tortures me. If they freed me from this prison, if that railroad train was mine, I bet I'd move it on a little farther down the line. Far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. And I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
All right, what's going on now? What were you saying? Where are you working at now in there, in the prison system? Where are you working now?
I work canteen.
Oh, remember? Dude. Now I remember. But isn't that like, doesn't that like shoot you in the foot though? Because, you know, like you got, you know what I'm saying? But I got, you know what I'm talking about. Like, I'm sure, like, you know what I'm talking about. That doesn't shoot you in the foot?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm right here, man. Like, hey. I was going to say, that doesn't hurt you by not working tonight?
We did everything we were supposed to do today. So we just wait until Monday.
Hey, when you were working during Christmas, was there extra Christmas bags?
That was a few left.
How many did you get?
I got like just one.
Oh, okay. Well,
that was one left.
Okay. A big bag? Was it like a $75 bag?
No, about 50. Yeah. That was all meat, like meat, cheese, and that's it. Yeah, I do a couple left, though. What you do for Christmas?
I went to my sister's with me and my kid and my friend George. We went over there, we ate, and then I came back here, and that was about it. Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Christmas, you know, I used to make a little meal, Then my neighbors, you know how it is, though.
Yeah, I know how it is, man. It's like, when it comes down to it, did you make a calzone?
No, we're just making regular hookah. Meat, beans, foreskin. That's it. Have a little bit fun, no? Hey, remember that I told you?
About what?
About Christmas.
What about Christmas? No, I don't remember. Tell me again.
I don't like Christmas. And here, I don't like Christmas.
Oh, yeah. A lot of guys say that, though. They don't like, they don't like any holiday in there.
Yeah. You know, everybody keep talking, oh, Christmas is, New Year is, and that. All right. It's good, you know, but, you know, and instead of, like me, instead of keep me up, I was down. I'll be down. You know?
Well, that's...
I mean, that's just me, huh?
Nah, that's because of that. That's because of what's going on right now. You know, all this uncertainty with your future. So that's understandable.
Nah, but this is almost the whole time I've been down.
Yeah.
I don't really like Christmas, New Year. You know, when all these holidays come, I can wait to pass by. You know, because you know, everybody keep saying, "Oh, Christmas is," you know. You know, if you would be outside, it would be different. You know, have some fun with your family or whatever. You know. Make a meal, you know, have some fun, stuff like this. But here, you know, it is different. Hey, but listen.
What?
I'm still fucking wait, man. To be outside. I know I'll be outside. I still have my hope up. You know?
How long you been waiting for a response? Like, is it legal for them? How long?
It's been like a year now.
Dude, that can't be legal, man. That cannot be legal. There's something, like, if it is legal, listen, there's something fishy about that, because if a judge already ordered that you can be released, and yet they're keeping you past that release date, right? They're like, they're basically like,
yeah, but they got it right to hold me until everything got decided.
Do you know what that means? That's like saying, no, they could keep you there for 45 years and say, well, because in the courts it took like, I'm being sarcastic, but it's like saying that they could have the right, they could keep you in the courts for like 3 years and say, well, you know, it took 3 years, or it took, there's got to be a statute that about. There has to be a statute where there's a deadline for a decision to be made, a finalized decision.
How about the state? The state can write a motion to the court to ask for an extension of the time.
So that's like saying, how many extensions are they allowed?
I think there are three.
How long is each extension?
Three. So far, I haven't get any. Because, you know, they would send me a copy to me. And so far, I haven't get any.
Hey, you got the number? You got the information for the consulate in Mexico? The constable? Yeah. You need a... Well, if I say you need to, I know what it's like to have to, you know, listen. I would suggest you write to the constable and... the Mexican embassy here in the U.S. Like, there might be one in Wisconsin.
One in Milwaukee.
Okay, well, for my opinion, what's the address? Like, you said there's one in Milwaukee, though, right? I got your information, because I don't know, man. Maybe I'll have to go down there. I don't hold me to that, but... I'll call them and give them your info, because this is ridiculous. This is, you know what?
Hey, I do that. I write to them and they told me, hey, we cannot do nothing right now, because everything is in the court of appeals. We cannot tell the judge what he has to do.
Todas las llamadas que no sean hechas propiamente a un abogado pueden ser monitorizadas y grabadas.
Yeah, they told me they cannot do nothing. So I just, all I can do is just wait.
Yeah, hey, is that CEO Walker still on your unit?
No, he I think he's in investigation.
So he's not working anymore?
No, it's been now like about 3 or 4 months, maybe longer than it.
He hasn't been at RCI for like 3 or 4 months.
Yeah.
Dude, I bumped into him. Listen, I bumped into him on the street. I bumped into him at a thrift store. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh yeah. He was talking to me,
but I didn't ask him if he was still working there, but he had told me about that woman Bowen, the one that she got walked out for having sex with an inmate. And he said that they were trying to use him at RCI as a scapegoat for that.
Yeah.
And he said that he told them that she'd been, you know, having sex with inmates. And but you know, like for him, dude, that was such a cushion job, man. You just walk right in there, you know, that was such a cushion job, man. The way, you know, you seen how he worked it. Like he was in there, he's watching, dude, it was a cushion job, man. And he had seniority, like he was getting paid a lot of money. That's why he was coming in with that fancy watch.
Yeah.
But see, you know what happens? This is why even I said, I even think of this to myself. And I think of King David when I think of this, where we have to pump our brakes. Yeah. You know, there's times where we have to pump our brakes because we could get too big of a head. We can get too comfortable.
Yeah.
And that's something that we got to be mindful of, being too comfortable. And with him, there's times where, you know, just, you know, being too comfortable, and that can come back at you. That's why you got to, like, separate. You got to separate stuff. And, you know, him, you know, joking with the inmates. And, I mean, man, you know, too comfortable. But I say that to myself, too, man. And, you know, I got to be mindful, too. I can get too comfortable. And then all of a sudden, all kind of calamity will come. And then I'll be saying to myself, I knew better. I knew better.
Yeah. That's true, though, you know. You're right.
I am right. Oh. I know. Yeah.
Yeah. Like I said, he's been out like 3 or 4 months. I didn't know that until somebody was talking about that. Down the break. I said, oh shit, I didn't know that. Yeah. Well, you know, we'll see what happens. Somebody said he's about to
coming
back. I don't know if
it's
true or not.
Yeah, he probably, it's like that woman, Bueno. Remember Bueno?
Yeah, yep.
Did she ever come back?
No, she went to the different joint.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I think she went to the riot, I think. Yeah, she went to riot. Hey.
What?
But you know, people say he's gonna come back. If they don't find nothing on it, he's gonna come back.
Well, he'll sue.
You
know, he'll
all
sue.
Those months, all those months he don't work. Hey, they say they gotta pay to him.
Yeah.
Overtime and all that.
I'm sure he's collecting. I'm sure he's collecting unemployment right now.
I asked you about you still work out, right?
No, I don't work out no more, man.
Why? What happened?
I'm too big, man. I'm too big to work out, man. What?
Do for your own healthy. You know, you gotta
be healthy, man. I'm healthy. Like I'd rather do cardio. I'd rather like play basketball. I'd rather work out. Yeah, when I can, but right now the weather's cold.
But yeah, I know.
But when I can play basketball, yeah, you know, I'll go out there and I'll shoot some hoops.
Yeah. Me, I still do my routine here and there, you know. When it's a nice day, I'll just go outside and do my workout. I haven't been in the gym because they keep closing me.
Yeah, I heard that. Somebody told me that another guy I talked to, he said that they shut everything down. You guys,
in the weekend.
Look, I heard that when it comes to training day, you guys can't even, they don't even let you guys come out your cell now for training day. Is that true?
Yeah. We gotta be in our rooms. We ain't got no courier, phone, not even shower.
Yeah, that's ridiculous, man. That's really absurd.
They say they're gonna do it twice a month. So, see what happens. They keep doing stuff like that. They keep doing it. You know, because nobody say nothing. You know. Yeah. What you want to do this weekend?
I'm going to work on my podcast. I got this podcast that I do.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I do. I plan on buying another microphone. I plan on getting another web camera and then working on intros. Yeah. Like you remember He-Man, the cartoon? Remember the cartoon He-Man?
Yeah.
Well, I did it.
Yeah, I remember.
I use some of the material from He-Man, the cartoon, for one of my podcasts.
Yeah,
yeah, like, you know how He-Man starts off? It's like, dun, 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 dun. Well, what I did was I used the original He-Man for the beginning of the show, and I named it that. But instead of saying He-Man, I had He-Man say He-Manwich. Because the podcast is called The Manwich Show. So every time he says He-Man, he says He-Manwich. You know, I did the same thing for the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. And when it say Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Heroes in a Half Shell, Turtle Power, well, what I did was I had to say Teenage Mutant Ninja Manwich. And then like the Transformers, I did the same thing with the original Transformers. I had to say, Manwich Formers, more than meets the eye. What I want to do next is what I want to do next, though, I want to use the A-Team. You know, the A-Team with Mr. T and them? I want to call it the M-Team for Manwich, the name of the podcast. So these are things I plan on doing with shows from the 80s and the 90s, maybe even the 70s, you know. Yo.
Yeah, it's good, though.
It takes time.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah, it is.
It does take time, though. Yeah, it does take time. But I'm trying.
You know, it's good. It's good keeping you busy, you know.
Yep. And that's what it does. You know, it definitely keeps me busy.
You still going to church?
Right now, they wouldn't. Well, I do. I plan on going to church this Sunday. But, like, you know, like, they're, like, trying to keep me from going to church and all this jazz, man. Yeah.
Todas las llamadas que no sean hechas propiamente a un abogado pueden ser monitorizadas y grabadas.
See, check it out. I went to check. What they say? We got a minute left.
Yeah.
All right. Listen, I'll tell you real quick. I was going to church, right? I was going to church.
Yeah.
And then And I, one day I had this ankle bracelet on, and it was going. Something happened, and
queda un minuto.
I went home, right? I went to my apartment, that is. And these cops came and they arrested me, right? So I'm sitting in this MSDF. Anyhow, they were like trying to punish me for going to church. Yeah, they were like, you can't go to church. And I'm like, what do you mean I can't go to church? They're like, you can't go to church? What? I know we got a minute left. What's up?
Yeah.
Let's pray. God the Father.
I want to tell you
God the Father, in Jesus' name, we come to you in prayer, and we pray for Chepe. We ask God the Father that you would free Chepe from prison and get him back home to his mom and his family in Mexico, God the Father. We ask that you'd seek to be glorified in this, and may you raise this man up to be a vessel of your mercy. In Jesus' name we ask, and we both say amen.
Amen.
Hey, look, man, I love you. Keep calling me, and I'll keep posting these videos.
Okay.
Let me know if you
I'll call you tomorrow.
Let me know if you get a pen pal.